We're going to build this, and it's an IoT dev board. What is IoT?
Internet of Things.
So what we have is a breadboard for developing our various projects. And we have the Raspberry Pi and an Arduino. And this is a relay board. And this is a power supply. This is a variable power supply. And so the placement of this, the purpose of some of the placement is the Arduino can be run directly from the Pi. And the Pi runs the Arduino IDE, so you can do all your programming on the Pi. So once you develop a project in this configuration and you have it deployed, you can remote into the Pi and access your programming for your Arduino. And so the point of this is you would be running a project where you're using the robust processor of the Arduino to run your project, and all the reporting and HTTP stuff is handled by the Pi. Because if you have a power failure and the power comes back on, the Arduino is super dependable at coming back on and doing what it's supposed to do, whereas the Pi, not so much. If the power gets cut on the Pi, it might get corrupt, it might come back on. It's not quite super dependable. So in this configuration, the workhorse is going to be the Arduino and the reporter, and the one that's telling you everything that's going on and gives you remote access is going to be the Pi. And so we've also got a monitor we're going to use with this, and that's the most expensive part, about $100. Everything else here is pretty cheap. And the monitor's optional. If you have one already at home, you can use that. Or you can run it headless, which means you're accessing it remotely. And so what we've done here is these are plastic standoffs. And so we just put the standoffs on the boards first, just placed them on here, marked them, drilled them, and then glued them into place. So let's look at the bottom of that board. We just glued them all. And that way, if you fry a board, you can just unscrew these and replace the board. And so this basically gives you several power supply options. This is a little USB LED, so to give you an idea how that would work. We'll turn that on. And that gives you just a little bit of light for your project, but it also lets you test your USB power. Okay, so what we're going to start off with is we have all of the holes marked to place our components, and we're going to drill them. And so with this board that I've chosen, it's just a standard clipboard. You can get these for a buck or two at the grocery store or whatever store has a stationery department. And the reason I used this larger clip style, they have these too, but it has a smaller clip. But it gives you the option of clipping one of these rechargeable batteries in. And these make good project batteries because they can power a Pi or an Arduino. And this particular one is able to be charged and discharged at the same time. So that makes it a UPS, or uninterruptible power supply. You knew what that was, right? Okay, so that's what that's for. So whatever size you end up with one of these as a power supply option, and we have some other power supply options we're going to do too. And I have these little legs. It's going to have a few things sticking out of the back, so I wanted it to have some legs. So we're going to drill the legs first, so we have it lifted off the surface so we can drill the rest of the holes. Who wants to drill first? Okay. Can you handle that thing? Both hands. So I'm going to lift this. First, we're going to do these corner holes. Okay. You need it straight up and down. And sometimes when you first start drilling, it travels a little bit. We'll be right back. we're going to do is go ahead and goober these up and we'll stick it in. So give me, let's try it. Let's try putting a drop in each hole and see how that works. One more, the next one. It's okay, just keep going. You have to do it quick because I have to get this thing in for a cool. Good. Good. You just put it right in that line right there and cut. Squeeze, there we go. And so that's what we're gonna make our plug out of, is that little thing right there. Yeah, so that one goes close to you. I'll move our light there. So we're like trying to plug the thing in. Can we get a progress report on the plugging the thing in?
It's still in it. It's like teeny bitty out. Like.
So the way this works is these buttons here, they just switch from the input voltage to the output voltage. And these buttons here change the output voltage. So if I wanted to change it to 5 volts, that brings it up to 5 volts. And if you press and hold, then it'll move one at a time. So 5 volts would run either the Pi or the Arduino, but some Arduino boards run on 3.3 volts. And there are various boards that do run on 3.3. So that's an adjustable power supply. And that will power this rail here all the way to that breakpoint. And anything past here won't be powered by that. So you might plug a battery pack into this rail to power something else. And the reason why you want different power supplies is, for example, if we're running this relay board, sometimes it's a bad idea to power things that require real electricity or sort of high power. It's not good to power those off your boards. It's better to have a separate power supply for things like that. But these have actual coils in them, and so they can possibly have a little bit of backlash, or basically a back current. They will work off the Arduino, but it's not a good idea. Especially if we're powering the Arduino from the Pi. And so here we have the regular blink program running one of the relays on the relay board.
Yep, it's got it.
Try playing a video. See if it'll play. We don't have any speakers hooked up, but I have some handy here.
Okay, what plays?
Yeah, it plays. So in order to get audio, we will need to hook up an audio speaker to the output on the Pi, which is right there. If I can focus it in, there we go.
We're gonna do some more projects with this board.
Next up, we're gonna do a little bit of soldering. Stay tuned. And if you're new, subscribe and, oh, What's that bell thingy? Yeah, we already said that.
Okay.
I'm like, what does IoT dev boy mean? And it means like internet, something about internet.